Warming up is a very important part of your daily practice and should be taken very seriously and comprehensively in your approach. I'm going to share with you my basic warm-up that incorporates a lot of the basic concepts that I like to use when I play in general. The first exercise I always do is some form of long tone. Here's an example of long tone plus vowel singing. Usually I like to think very horizontal in the long tone and do some sort of bending. For example, I can do a half step bend downwards with my tongue, not my lips, and also a half step up in the fingering, but keeping the pitch the same. Here's an example. After this horizontal long tone and bending, which gets my lips in the proper oo formation, a lot of thickness of the lips inside the cup of the mouthpiece, I like to do what I call vowel singing. This is utilizing the five vowels A, E, I, O, and U. Now, in some of these examples, I'm going to try to use my hand while I play to show you what my tongue is doing. For example, ah, e, ah, or e, ah, e. Very important on the lower register when you're moving from a higher note to a lower note that the tongue comes all the way down into the ah or o position. And also going from low to high, make sure that in the high register your tongue arch goes all the way into an e position. Therefore, you don't have to strain with the lips and you don't have to exaggerate the opening too much in any register. It should feel that your register is close together and not wide apart. Now, one thing I'd like to suggest is if you have difficulty with some of the intervals in the high register, for example, high G to high C, you can put what I call a chromatic connector in between those notes to keep that horizontal feel and keep a universal position in your embouchure. Once I feel that I have a nice horizontal feel in the Clark studies and my articulation is very responsive, particularly in the middle and the low register, I find it much easier to move higher. Thank you. So I love all of the scale work in Armin. You can slur it, you can legato tongue it, and you can staccato tongue it. You can also double tongue it. I like to incorporate arpeggio work after my scales, and one of my favorite exercises for arpeggiated work is from the Herbert L. Clarke book of diminished sevenths. So here, again on my C trumpet, I'm working through two octaves, and I'm going to slur it first with my best sound, and then I'm going to tongue it. When I'm tonguing, especially in two octaves or larger, I like to really concentrate on the ends of the notes so that I'm not anticipating the dip either down or up. So you should hear kind of a bookend approach that each note has a full duration, even if it's in staccato. In the violin intervals, make sure that you try to maintain the feel of the middle G horizontal all the way through to the end of the exercise. Breathe wherever you like, and it doesn't have to be strict in tempo. Generally speaking, I start a bit faster and I slow down as the exercise gets wider in the intervals. Try not to anticipate the direction that you're going. Stay in real time with the note that you're on before you leap to the higher or lower note. Use your best sound and support well with the diaphragm to keep a horizontal feel. At the end of my warm-up, I always try to play some sort of an etude or a lyrical study, something to kind of wrap up all of the concepts that I used in my warm-up. And one of my favorites is the etude number 1 from Clarke's first set of studies. You can slur it, you can single tongue it, you can triple tongue it, you can double tongue it, however you feel on that day. This case, I'm slurring it and I'm trying to keep a very even horizontal sound, and also I want to hear all of the pitches chromatically. Sometimes it's very easy for us to feel like we're faking some of the half steps, and you should hear every half step here, hopefully. And again, I would call this an advanced technique. Try to do it in one breath so you'll gain more flexibility this way. And the last thing I'll say is to make sure that your warm-up every day is comprehensive. This is a short video. It doesn't represent all of the exercises that I do, but it's a pretty well-rounded and comprehensive group of exercises from my basic warm-up level 1. Good luck, and I hope you enjoy it.